Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video. This is part of a blog hop as we celebrate the new Inkpad release by Altenew. So they have released 12 new colors, you can get them as a set of 4, and I have the oval sets here, but you can also get them separately, and they come in a form of ink cubes as well, which are more economical and easier to store. So the first set is called Sugar Plums and Lovely Shades of Purple. This is the Fall Harvest set in lovely warm yellows, and I will be using these colors today on my card so you can see them all in action. And finally, my most favorite from all the colors, it's this one. This is called Tranquility in lovely blue grays, which I absolutely love, and I will be using all these colors on my card today so you can see them in action as well. Now, this video is part of a blog hop. There is lots of inspiration along the blog hop and lots of giveaways, so make sure to visit my blog. You will find the link down below and under the giveaways. For my card today, I will be using the new stamp set, which is called Modern Fox and the Matching Ties, and I'm going to stamp the fox as well as the tree. So I have a piece of Nina Solar White cardstock here. I'm going to place my images on top, and it doesn't matter where I'm going to place them. I will be using my dies later on to cut them out. So for the tree, there is also another stamp that you stamp on top for the tree trunk, and for the fox, there are a couple more stamps that you can layer on top. Now you can see I'm preparing the stamps here. These are solid stamps and I'm using them for the first time. So I like to prep them like that, or you can use an eraser. This way I will get a good impression once I stamp, which is not going to be splotchy. For the fox, I will be using inks from the Fall Harvest set, and I'm starting with Pumpkin Pie. And I'm using my Misty here so that I can stamp a second time to add some shadow. So I have the first layer here, and now without moving the stamp, I'm going to switch to another color. This time I'm going with yellow ochre, and this is a touch darker. And I'm touching the inkpad only at the base of my fox, just to add a touch of shadow there. You can blend it out with your finger, stamp on top, and you will see that I get a lovely shadow, which is not going to be as vibrant as it looks now once the inks are going to dry. So I will end up having a lovely blending there. There are two more stamps that you can layer on top, one that gives the details for the nose and the eyes, and the other one gives the details of the feet. So I'm stamping those with brown ink, and that's Espresso. Now you can leave the fox as it is, it looks wonderful. But I decided to go back with black ink this time. I'm going to touch the ink pad at the very bottom of the feet just to darken them up a little bit, as well as I'm going to stamp the nose and the eyes. So I'm not inking up the whole stamp, although it looks like I'm doing so. I'm being very careful to ink up only a few parts. I'm going to close the door of my Misty, and my fox is ready. Now we'll move on and do the stamping of the tree, and as I'm going for a winter scene card, I am going to use the blue grays from the new set, which is called Tranquility. Absolutely love those colors, and just for a completely different look, I decided to go with a lighter color for my tree, which is Misty Morning, and I'm going to stamp it one more time on top. I'm not switching to a darker ink pad, I'm just using the same one at the very bottom, just to add a touch of shadow. It's not going to be as dark as it looks now. Once it dries, it's going to have a lovely blending. I'm going to place on top the second stamp that gives you the tree trunk and all the branches. And for that, I will go with a second shade, which is called Cloudy Sky, a lovely color again. I absolutely love this set of blues. And the truth is that I didn't have any ink pads in that shade of blue. My favorite colors are blue, and I didn't have any in blue grays. So I'm really happy with this release. And again, here I'm adding some shadows only at the base with the same ink pad again and again, just to darken up a little bit the bottom of the tree. Now I'm going to use the matching dies. I line them on top. I will secure them with purple tape just to make sure that they are not going to move on me, and run them through my die cutting machine. And I end up having two lovely focal points for my card. Now I will be using the two darker shades from the Tranquility set, and these are Nimbus and Dark Knight. I have a piece of cardstock here that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm using an ink blending tool to apply my ink. Now don't worry if it looks splotchy, I'm going to make sure that I saturate the color a lot, so no splotches are going to show at the end. Also, once this ink dries, it's going to blend nicely and evenly, and it's not going to look as it looks at the moment, so don't be afraid to go ahead and ink with those ink pads. For inking, I'm using my Rectangle Old blending tools by Ranger, and I'm using those just because they have a bigger area, so they make my life easier and I can cover up my cardstock quicker. And you can see I ended up having a lovely background, no harsh lines. Everything is nicely blended, and I have that lovely ombre look from darker to lighter. Now this is going to be my background, the sky, for my winter scene. For that I will be using one of my stitched rectangle dies, and I'm going to cut it to size. This is going to be slightly smaller than the standard card. Now I used my embossing bag, where I'm going to stamp now, just to remove static electricity. I'm using my embossing ink and I'm stamping the sentiment. This comes from the same Modern Fox stamp set as the rest of my images, and I'm stamping the one that says cold days, warm heart. I think this is a lovely winter card. I will apply white embossing powder, and before you do this step, before you go ahead and do the embossing, make sure that the ink underneath is completely dry, otherwise with all that inking the embossing powder is going to stick all over the place. Now I used a couple of dies to cut out those slopes out of white cardstock, and I stuck the first one directly on top of my base by using glue at the back, and for the second one I did add some foam tape at the back just to add some dimension. And for the tree I'm going again completely flat with my tape at the back. Now I don't know if you can tell, but I have a smudge there, a little boo-boo, out of brown ink, or maybe the yellow one, which I need to cover up, so I'm going to strategically place my fox on top of the tree to cover up that completely. So I'm going to use my tape at the back of my panel, and I have a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to stick the panel on top. And you can call this card done, or if you are like me and you never stop with little details, I decided to add some shiny stars. I have these teeny tiny silver stars, and I'm going to stick them all over the background. I think with all those blue grays, silver goes beautifully. It completes the look that I am going for, and it definitely looks better than using gold stars. So I end up having a cold winter scene, which I absolutely love. Down below the description area you will find a link to the giveaways, as well as a list of all the supplies that I used today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, like and subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you all next time.